When men age and the prostate starts enlarging, many complain of weak urinary stream at night that normalizes during the day. If this sounds like you, let me ask you a question. Did you ever meet a doctor who could provide you with an explanation? I bet your answer is no. Urologists all around the world know this phenomenon. It's a common complaint. Yet the central question remains unanswered. Why? The answer is very simple. Every specialty concentrates on their own stuff. I think you know that saying, if you only own a hammer, every problem becomes a nail. Weak urinary stream at night can only be explained by true interdisciplinary thinking. Urology alone isn't enough. Neurology and sleep medicine are needed too. You want an explanation for your problem? Then follow me into a fascinating deep dive where I explain to you what is going on. And in case you're here for a solution, I might be able to help you with that too. My name is Dr. Stefan Buntrock and I'm a board-certified urologist. It all starts with potty training. Yes, you heard me right. Many years ago at a congress, I remember a scientific poster with a memorable title about childhood micturition. It said, "Wee-wee when we want." In other words, when we are born, wee-wee when urge strikes, not holding back. But don't worry, we've got diapers. This is what we call reflex micturition. The bladder fills, special detectors on the bladder wall tell the brain, bladder is full, and here we go. When we get older and our brain becomes more mature, we learn how to control it so we don't pee into Auntie Mary's face when she changes our diapers. This usually happens around the age of 3. At age 4 to 5, we usually learn to stay dry during the night. How do we do it? The brain builds two control centers. One is in the brainstem and one is in the forehead called the prefrontal cortex. They stop the micturition reflex and give you the freedom, well, to wee when you want. So what's the difference between them? The one in the brainstem, let's call it the pontine control center, is active more or less day and night. The prefrontal cortex is only switched on during the day when you are awake. In a way, the prefrontal control center is more powerful. During the day when it says go, it also overrides the pontine control center at the same time. But that's not all. Prefrontal activity enables you to strain. When you sleep, the prefrontal cortex goes into regeneration with the rest of the brain. When you wake up to pee, well, you're awake, but you're still drowsy. And so is your prefrontal cortex. This means potentially less power, especially if you have an enlarged prostate that inhibits free flow a little. But that's not all. The autonomic nervous system may also be altered at night. And this may just be the last piece of the puzzle that tips the system over the edge. Before I move on, I'd love to have you as a subscriber of UroChannel. If you like my content, it would be natural to give it some applause. In the digital world, this means subscribing and liking. It doesn't cost you anything, and it is a polite gesture to signal me your support. Thank you. And thank you all subscribers and members. I'm happy to have you as my loyal fans. So let's move back to the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous systems. They do things out of your control. I am talking about breathing, heartbeat, digestion, blood pressure, and so on. When it comes to your bladder, the parasympathetic nervous system serves two very important functions. For micturition, it activates the bladder muscle and relaxes the bladder neck and sphincter muscle. The sympathetic nervous system does the opposite. It closes the bladder neck and relaxes the bladder muscle. So what does that mean? Too much sympathetic activity will result in a weak urinary stream. Just imagine that happening at night. Now you can't really squeeze properly because your prefrontal cortex is still napping. This is exactly what's happening to so many men at night. But what did they do for increased sympathetic activity? Usually during the night, the parasympathetic system rules. You need it for regeneration and repair. Sympathetic tone is disruptive. We don't want it while we sleep. It disturbs REM, which is short for rapid eye movement, you typically experience 3 to 5 REM phases each night. This is also when you dream, by the way. REM is so important and so easily disturbed. This is why we also need to look into sleep medicine to understand what disturbs REM and what triggers sympathetic activity during the night. It can be something you may not be aware of. Sleep apnea is very common, but you wouldn't know if you had it. It causes micro awakenings because you stop breathing during your sleep. It's called micro awakenings because you don't fully wake up, but it is enough to mess up REM. Then there is grinding your teeth while you sleep. That's a very common pathology in sleep medicine. It also disturbs REM. But then, we are not only talking about things beyond your control. Bad sleep habits may cause sympathetic activity as well. This is alcohol or caffeine immediately before bedtime. Watching UroChannel on your smartphone before you sleep. Blue light from screens is not good for your day and night rhythm. These are things within your control and you can change them. For sleep apnea, you will need professional help, of course. So, why does your urinary stream normalize during the day? Two reasons. First, the prefrontal cortex is back. Second, daytime activity balances sympathetic against parasympathetic activity. Did you know that we spend 1/3 of our lives sleeping? That's a lot of time. But do we know what influence it has on our well-being and how it might trigger health conditions nobody understands? No. Sleep is the dark side of the moon. Never seen, unexplored. If you are interested, I started a mini-series about sleep-related issues in urology. I call it Urology Noir. Here's the playlist. Let me guide you through the night. I know the way.